स्टार्ट कीजिए। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर विच इज मॉडल। द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मॉडल इज हियर, इट हैज बीन डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब, मीन्स models have been derived from auxiliary verb. Now models have been classified under the phase of classification which has been written as under. Models have been classified as under: number 1 is shall, number 2 is will, number 3 is should, number 4 is would, number 5 is may, number 6 is might, number 7 is can, number 8 is could, number 9 is must, number 10 is used to, number 11 is ought to, number 12 is need, and number 13 is dare. So models have been classified into 13 forms which have been mentioned here as shall, will, should, would, may, might, can, could, must, used to, ought to, need, and dare. Now, special features of model have been mentioned here. Number 1, models don't follow tense pattern. It doesn't follow tense pattern. Number 2 is, it is used along with all subjects in the same way, whether the subject be singular or plural. Number 3, whenever we use model in a sentence, we use V1 form, that is base form of verb is used along with the model when it is used in sentences. Now we have to study regarding the usage of model. Number 1 is shall. In general term, shall is used along with I and we to denote futuristic action. But when will is used along with I and we, it denotes certain action, that is security of action taken by the subject. Second, will. It is used along with he, she, it, you, and they to denote futuristic action. But when shall is used along with he, she, it, you, they, it is used to denote certain action taken by the subject, that is security of action. In this way, we use shall and will along with different subjects, whether it is singular or plural. Number 3 is should. This should as a model used to give advice or suggestion. For example, if I say you should read properly. Number 4 is would. It is also a model and past form of will. It is used to denote past actions under which past actions are recalled by the subject. May, it indicates possibility, means the subject is in position to take some action which is under possibility, not surety. For example, if I say you may pass the exam, means you are not certain to pass the exam. If I say you can pass the exam, means you are capable to pass the exam. Might is the past form of may, which is used to denote past possible action taken by the subject. Can is such kind of a model which is used to denote capacity or capability of an individual. For example, if I say he can pass the exam means he is capable to pass the exam. Could is the past form of can, which is used to denote past capability of an individual. For example, if I say he could speak, but at present he is not in a position to speak, means the person is suffering from the disability of hearing. Before that one, he used to speak, but at present he is not in a position to speak. Must is used to denote a strict instruction that is under obligation or compulsion. For example, you must read properly. It means you are strictly instructed by someone to study properly. Used to, it is used to denote past action notions taken by the subject. For example, if I say he used to sing, वह गाया करता था, but at present he is not in a position to sing. He used to run, but at present he is not in a position even to walk. Means, in past days, he was the person who used to run, दौड़ा करता था. Ought to is used to denote obligatory or moral actions taken by the subject. For example, if I say, you ought to respect your elders, means it is under moral obligation that you must to respect your elders. Need and dare are used as main verb as well as modal. For example, he need not go there. उसे वहां जाने की जरूरत नहीं है. It is used as modal. But if I say, he is in position, in need to have money. He needs rupees 100. It is verb. And need has been used here as verb. In the similar way, dare. How did you dare to go there? It is used as verb. He dare not to go there. It is used as modal. So in this way, we come to know the uses of all the modals which have been mentioned here. Basically, keeping in mind the special features of modals. And in this way, when we practice over it, we come to confirm and have confirmation regarding the concept of modals. Thank you very much.